and overcrowding in most schools in the Gari Timpani district is affecting teaching and learning. Eva Atibuka reports that a class could have about 140 pupils.
The Garu DA Primary School, established in 1996, is struggling with a population of over 1,000 in the kindergarten and primary levels. Whilst the number of pupils keep increasing, infrastructure remains the same.
It's one of the oldest schools in the district, and because of the hard work of the teachers, everybody would like the child or the ward to come to DA. And one teacher handling over 100 and something students or pupils in a class is very, very challenging.
The least class size is 118. Classrooms are overly crowded, generating intense heat.
We are not feeling comfortable.
Why?
Because every day we are sweating, and some of us, we have disease in ourselves. So if our sweat touch either disease, our population is too many.
You know, by the time you realize you step on somebody's leg, you step on somebody's hands, because you have to move around to see what they are doing. KG children, they are not like the elderly children where you can sit, stand afar and look at them. You have to supervise, you have to go around, observe what they are doing.
Teachers say the situation is affecting teaching and learning.
Now that they are technically populated, it's difficult for one teacher to handle such a number of people. As a professional teacher, when I teach, I have to assess them. And by so doing, you can imagine, if I'm going to assess them and I give at least the minimum 5 questions and I'm going to mark, it will take me 1 hour more than that.
When we do an exercise, I let them exchange their books. And when they exchange their books, we'll write all the correction on the boards and I'll let them mark their colleagues' books.
The district assembly has promised to fix the problems.
This shouldn't happen in this era. This time around, government policy that people should not travel that distance. But there are some other communities where they walk for over 5-6 kilometers to go to school. That is where our attention or our concentration will be. We have budgeted for it for this year under this DDF facility. And I'm sure that by the close of 2015 or early 2016, early, they should have a school block.
Meanwhile, the Garu Timpani district is rehabilitating 20 dams and constructing 2 new ones to boost agriculture. Well, district authorities say this is expected to show up investment in the sector.
Farmers are beginning to reap the benefits of investment in the sector. Dry season farming, a major activity and source of income for residents, is greatly picking up. Men, women and children are all into dry season farming. The major headache with the old dam is inadequate water. Farmers then rely on dugout water sources. Hassana is a final year junior high school pupil and farming is part of his routine for the day.
I come here after school. I live with my grandparents and that is what I do to take care of them and to also pay my fees and buy books. But water for our activities is the main problem.
The district's over 30 dams and dugout wells are silted and the assembly has hinted 20 out of the 30 have been earmarked for rehabilitation. Officials working on the dams have assured TV3 of speedy work.
We are about 30% into the whole thing, and I think in the next couple of months, 3 or 4 months' time, we should be about 90%. We've done excavation of material, deepening, and then we've packed boulders there in the field. We'll soon be bringing them in to reinforce the embankment.
Manager of the Baku East Small Scale Farmers Association's Rural Bank pledged support for the farmers.
Our commitment to assist farmers, we even had to pursue an on-lending loan to make sure we have sufficient funds to give to them. So fortunately for us, we have received that on-lending loan just at the beginning of this year to make sure we support disbursements to farmers groups.
The district is prioritizing dry season farming and exploring all avenues to make dry season farming a more vibrant economic venture for residents.
That is something that actually our people love to do because they are very hardworking, and if we had enough water in Garut and Pani district, I don't think anybody would want to travel down south looking for non-existent jobs, as we find most of our brothers and sisters down there trying to do this kaya ye and other miniature jobs for survival.